See, guys, this question which you asked is, what is Karma Yoga and how does it help? Okay. Our mind has three activity, three is in nature. Sattva Guna, Rajo Guna, Tamo Guna. In Tamo Guna, we become lazy. Rajo Guna, we become active. Sattva Guna, we become silent and meditative. So, nobody can be staying in any of these gunas permanently. The gunas keep shifting. Our skill is utilize these gunas for our spiritual evolution. So don't allow the mind to be idle. Tamo guna. Engage in some activity, rajo guna. You can engage in an activity which is beneficial for your family, earning money, it's okay. Then engage in an activity which will purify your mind. That Rajoguna you are utilizing it properly. When you engage in any activity for perfection of mind as selfless service, it's called Yadna. Or it's called Karma Yoga. So Karma Yoga purifies your mind. So the purpose of Karma Yoga is purification of the mind in Rajoguna. But the mind is predominantly Rajoguna. So, no, I have desire for purification of mind, that's perfectly okay. But in Karma Yoga, when you do some activity, you get fully engaged in the activity as a selfless service. So, give an example. If you are doing a hobby, in that hobby, you don't know how much time is spent. The time flies away. Because you are completely engaged in the hobby. So when there's no time, there's no space, there's no me, there's no ego. So then that activity becomes purifying. Whereas activity where I again and again I keep on focusing on the result or keep on focusing why I'm doing this, then activity becomes not Karma Yoga. For example, your son is studying for examination. He'll come and tell you, what is the guarantee that I'll get 90% mark? Why should I study? Then what you're telling me, just focus on your study. Do well. So, the focusing on the work is called Karma Yoga. Completely getting involved in the work. Then there's no me, there's no work, there's all oneness. And that is actually, Karma Yoga is a meditation in action. So, if you think that meditation is closing the eyes and doing something, no, that's in Sattva Guna. In Rajo Guna, completely engaged in your activity is called without expecting the future. Just being totally, so that you are completely there, you don't know how much time has passed. So that is called meditation in action. Meditation in action is called Karma Yoga. That can be any work. It can be household work, it can be service, where you are completely engaged in the activity. So that's where Buddhist monks have practiced. Where they do there's a mandala or rangoli. Where they keep on, they actually take 6 months for them to complete one rangoli, big rangoli. Very fine detail they go. They go into every small detail. That actually is called mindfulness or meditation in action. So that is required when our mind is Rajoguna. And nobody can have pure Sattvaguna or pure Rajoguna. It will shift between two. How to engage the mind in both the gunas is our challenge. Then if the mind becomes sattva guna, then you naturally sit. You don't get involved in the work. You may sit silently. But a person who is meditative also can't sit 24 hours silently. He'll have to, rajoguna will come. Then he'll have to work. Then he'll have to do selfless service. So like that selfless service and meditation is together, what we call as Atmano Mokshartam Jagadita. It's a combination. It's not one, it's not single practice. So are you doing Karma Yoga? How do you know? If you're doing Karma Yoga, you are so much involved in that you don't know how much time has passed. In that passage of timelessness, you are no longer there. There's no ego. There's only pure awareness. That's actually meditation in action. A jnani is not a state. Jnani is always in a state of activity where there is no doership. So if you are able to do this, gradually Karma Yoga becomes Naishkarmya. I am not doer. The complete actions are happening. spontaneously, then it's not individual action, divine action, God's action. So the whole purpose of karma yoga is from kamya karma to nishkama karma to naishkarmya. That's called naishkarmya siddhi. Now this is the path of karma yoga. And there is a path of jnana yoga and bhakti yoga. That's also fine. But ultimately, you have to choose a path where your mind in rajoguna can be engaged actively for purifying yourself. You take any activity which will help you. So if you think that meditation is sitting with closed eyes, that's also meditation because you're watching your thoughts and being aware of thoughts. Engaging fully in activity also is meditation because that time any thought comes, you're just dropping it. You're aware of intruding thoughts. You're just focusing on one thought. Concentration you're developing. So if you look at Ramana Maharshi's teaching, he says what is the sign of spirituality is a concentration in one activity or complete relaxation is also both, either this or that, both is a sign of spiritual evolution. So concentration on activity is called meditation, dhyana. So they are not opposite of each other. Activity and silence, they are not opposite. They are one complement of each other. There is one whole. So when I do an activity, when we get involved in activity, we go into detail, very fine detail, and that detail helps us to focus our mind. Of course, we should not bring in any selfishness or what will happen after this. Completely focused on the sake of work. So now that skill which you learn, you can apply in your life in meditation when you close your eyes. So path of karma yoga is from nishkamya karma, selfish action, nishkama karma, selfless service for purification of the mind, to naishkarmya, non-doership, where there is no individual. The naishkarmya is mukti, liberation. Are there any questions?
No, Guruji.
Okay.